What's up, guys, and welcome back to the Pro Dota English channel. We're covering the National Cup. We have another best of two on the way. It's going to be Bosnia going up against Turkey, or Pub Players if you prefer. I'm Mike Loris, going to be joined by Grandis V, and yes, I did forget to make the call happen, but it's working now. Everyone, no one panic, we're good. Bosnia going up against Turkey. I saw Turkey yesterday in the Game Show Cup, and they looked real good. Beat Monkey Freedom Fighters pretty convincingly. Bosnia, well, I mean, they're no slouches themselves, but we'll see if they can take Turkey down, as Turkey are currently tied with Finland, actually, for first place. I'm Mike Loris, going to be joined by Grandis V for this two-game set. How are you doing, dude?
Doing all right, and hopefully it is a very good two-game set. Should be entertaining games at the very least, and to start things off, there's not much deviation from the norm. Shadowfiend, Winter, Wyvern, Nightstalker, Doomband out, and Bosnia are going to snag themselves up a first pick IO.
Okay, well, this is a pretty decent way to start out for the Bosnia side. Again, 9 times out of 10 when you first pick IO, the secondary pick is going to be the Tiny, although we have seen a couple of teams deviate away. Svens, some gyrocopters even. But I like the Winter Wyvern band to try to protect this IO as best they can. You're never really going to fully protect it, although for Team Turkey, they may just want to say, okay, you can have the IO, you can have whatever partner you want. We're going to grab someone like a Tusk and a Queen of Pain or something like that, and we're just going to kill you in the lanes.
Yeah, they'll be very adept at doing that. Right now, they're going to have to somewhat find a way to deal with whatever this IO partnership is going to be. Probably Tiny is the one they'll prepare for the most, but right now it's just going to be a Queen of Pain. It feels like they're not going for direct counters to the IO Tiny, but rather just heroes that are going to be very good at getting on top of the IO, bursting it down, so that they are not able to benefit from that Tether Hero overcharge throughout the fights. And once you deal with the IO, Tiny is much more manageable.
And by doing this, it also kind of forces Bosnia's hand to ban out like the likes of Disruptor and Witch Doctor and Earthshaker, like those really good anti-IO Tiny heroes, just fearing that. That may or may not be in the game plan of Team Turkey right now. Like, they could just ignore that completely, but we see the Witch Doctor ban out, wouldn't be surprised to see maybe Disruptor straight after, but this is like kind of Team Turkey forcing the bans of Bosnia, and that makes it a little bit more awkward for Bosnia, since these bans might just be completely wasted. Who knows? I do like the Broodmother ban out, however. Broodmother with IO Tiny is very hard to deal with, because it's like the worst game of whack-a-mole in the world.
It really is. If you try to put pressure on the Broodmother, then IO Tiny will be in the other lane, wherever they want to be, really, with the Aghanim Scepter. Tiny can push at a very astonishing rate, and if you deal with the IO Tiny of the Broodmother, it's very, very hard to manage. And in general, Broodmother is a ban that I think most teams will consider in the second stage, because it is just that annoying to play up against, even if you have the appropriate wave clear for it. Next couple bans, Wraithing will be the ban coming out from Bosnia, and then a Venomancer for Turkey, as they pick up a Lina now, probably as their support.
We do have a lot of flexibility here. We have seen Necroman play the Queen of Pain and Lina both, so you could grab either one. I would say they have about the same matchup versus IO Tiny, maybe slightly better for Queen of Pain. You can't nuke them both super easily, but you at least can blink away so that if you do take an Avalanche and a Toss, that doesn't kill you. You will not die to right-clicks following that. Interesting to see now Bosnia grabbing the Bane. It's a pretty solid hero, and it does open the door for some even side lane Tiny plays, Nightmare into straight Avalotoss, but ooh, now we have a Shadow Demon coming out from the Team Turkey side. Did see them run almost this exact draft yesterday, I want to say. There was a whole bunch of games yesterday, so not exactly completely sure on that, but the Shadow Demon setup for Alina, that in and of itself hurts, and it locked it. I definitely did see them. I remember this now. They absolutely just locked down the enemy carry. They followed the Alchemist everywhere and killed him off like 4 times in 5 minutes. It was ridiculous.
And on top of the aggressive power, it's also very good defensively. With both the Disruption and the Snowball, there's a lot of ways to take your allies out of the fight if they are going to get jumped by a Bane or a Nyx or a Tiny, or whatever it might be. If you dodge that burst combination or the spells coming out from Bosnia, they'll find it very difficult to get kills. And just the disruptive force coming out from Turkey is going to be very interesting to watch. As far as Bosnia's pick is concerned, it is the Nyx Assassin, and I think this is a pretty good one. Although Shadow Demon and Lina are very good in their own right, it's a very intelligence-heavy draft coming out from Turkey, and I do like to see Nyx Assassin, especially when you have instant global follow-up with the IO Tiny. Nyx Assassin can scout out invis, especially with the more recent buffs to Vendetta, where you're 40 seconds invis at level 1. You can actually stay invis for a large portion of the game, which is completely different to how Vendetta worked before. Earlier Vendetta, you'd have to find your target, go to that lane, Vendetta in for the initiation. Now you can use it as more of a scouting tool around the map, and I think that's going to help out Bosnia a lot this game. They're going to be very momentum-based. If they get an early level 6 on the Nyx Assassin, get the relocation up for the IO, they can find a lot of global kills. Both of these teams are going to be playing cat and mouse on both sides, taking their turns as the cat and taking their turns as the mouse.
And you never really want to be the mouse, although Tom and Jerry teaches us otherwise. I mean, the great thing about Nyx Assassin in this game, as you said, you scout out for the IO Tiny, but you don't even have to risk the Vendetta into Impale. I mean, if you're going to like a Queen of Pain, you kind of want to just Impale straight out of Vendetta. Most of the time, you won't have enough damage afterwards. With the insane amount of damage that IO Tiny offer, just straight Impale out of Vendetta, except the fact that you're not going to be doing maximum damage, because Tiny does all the damage, and he does more than enough damage to kill off any given hero here for the Team Turkey side. Got a Lifestealer, though, as the pickup for Team Turkey. Now, this is not exactly going to be your most frequent pickup. That being said, Lifestealer does work pretty well with Queen of Pain, works pretty well with Tusk, and versus a Tiny, the matchup is actually decent. Like, I mean, he's obviously decent versus everyone else as well. Has to fear the Bane's grip, yes, but Crag Exterior, usually really good up against melee heroes, doesn't work up against the Rage of Lifestealer. And Tiny, for a good portion of the game until he gets his AC, has a lot of health and not much armor. And that's exactly what Lifestealer wants to be doing.
Yeah, perfect for him. I do hesitate for the Lifestealer pick, as you kind of already mentioned. The Bane is a very nice natural counter to the Lifestealer. At worst case scenario, the Bane's able to waste Lifestealer's rage time, and then that pseudo counter or soft counter against the Tiny's Craggy isn't going to come into play. And now we're going to have an Ember Spear for Bosnia, another very map mobile hero that can benefit off of these pickoffs. Across the board, though, I like the first four picks a lot better for Team Turkey. I think the Lina, Queen of Pain, Shadow Demon, and Tusk are going to be able to roam around so effectively getting these kills that if you just put the Lifestealer infested in one of them while they go for these ganks, he'll still be able to contribute inside these fights. And in general, I think their lineup's a little bit easier to execute. It kind of plays itself once you get those ultimates up. Whereas for Bosnia, there's going to be a lot more pressure for them to find the opportunities and to pounce on them rather than just, I don't know, going for smoke ganks whenever you have your cooldowns available for the enemy side. It's a lot harder to abuse relocate. But that said, I think they could snowball completely out of control. The Ember Spirit and the Tiny both could carry this game if given the appropriate amount of space.
Now, in this tournament, we have seen, I'm just trying to get some overlay things sorted out so everyone knows who's playing on which side. Yeah, it's going to be Radiant, Turkey, and Dire Bosnia. There we go. May look a little bit rough, but actually, no, screw it. It looks absolutely perfect. We're good. We have seen teams play in this tournament that are actually real teams that like play together in all the tournaments. And this is one of them coming out from Team Turkey, known as Pub Players, so you guys may or may not know about that. So, you know, just having a little bit of a track record, work with each other a little bit better, perhaps. Bosnia, I mean, they have been doing decently so far. They have 3 points, I believe. So it's not, you know, they're definitely in a decent position right now. But for the Bosnian side, they're obviously not as comfortable with one another. And that is maybe going to be reflected in their gameplay. But for right now, Turkey on the roam. Got Necroman on his trademark Queen of Pain. Shock is on the Shadow Demon. Klazinki on the Life. So there aren't T's on the Tusk. That is MDL on the Lina. Gonna place a pretty deep Observer Ward just to spot out the IO and Tiny's actions in the jungle.
And on the flip side of the coin, we're going to have Team Bosnia. Milan gonna be handling the Ember Spirit. FEGBL on the Bane. My goodness, Vita on the IO. Kendrick on the Tiny. And last but not least, it's going to be Pwn on the Nyx Assassin.
Oh, and luckily for him, he's gonna be wandering into the top lane, taking the right pathing to do so. Could have very easily been dropped if he ran into the gank train of Team Turkey, but taking a look at the lanes real fast for Turkey, it looks for the most part like they're going to be par for the course. You would expect Shock as well as the Lina MDL.
Oh, Lina. She's looking for the bottle snipe. When the IO sends us out at the 0 minute mark, if she could get that, that would have been huge, but eventually it's going to have to pull out. The bottle will be safely delivered. If she just waited a split second more, MDL would have been able to get it. Now on the retreat, bottle has been delivered, not going to find the courier either. That's a little bit sad. I was really hoping for that move to work.
That is not going to absolutely cripple this dual lane mid because they do have a little bit of health regen, but it would have made it so much easier for the Queen of Pain. And as I was saying, right when the courier was gunning out there, you would expect Shock and MDL to team up a hell of a lot. I don't really know how easy it is to kill off this IO Tiny combo, especially now that the bottle is up, but they are going to be looking 24-7, and they're actually going to find a pretty good angle right now. Blink forward from Necroman with the dagger as well. The tether out from Shock is going to get him straight to the creep wave. The Avalanche is going to slow down two heroes. Vita still taking some damage from the Shadow Strike, but this time the gank is going to fail. But that is just a small taste of the aggressive power that these two heroes are going to apply. It looks like, though, in the meantime, we're going to have a forced lane switch. Because the two supports are rotating out, the side lanes are having a little bit more trouble, especially the Lifestealer, who is decently self-sufficient, but no Gyrocopter.
Against a solo Nyx Assassin, should be all are doing all right. However, Nyx, low HP pool, high armor pool, is going to not be bothered too much by the Feast. It's a manageable lane, at the very least. Both sides could get kills, although it's unlikely. They'll probably just have the Lifestealer farming. But down towards the bottom lane, the Ember Spirit Bane going up against the Tusk for now might get partnered up with the Lina and the Shadow Demon. Now that he finds himself level 2, they could find themselves a kill. But again, it's very low probability. It kind of feels like both of these teams, although they're going to try to find aggressive moves, it's going to be difficult.
And the Observer Wards are going to keep people safe for most of the time, I would say. I mean, this Dire Observer Ward should be spotting any deep rotations towards the bottom lane. And if you jump the Nyx Assassin up towards top, expecting a setup into an LSA, well, Spike Carapace is just gonna put a stop to all of that. The easiest kill targets are in the mid lane, but that is also, there's two of them, so they're going to see you coming, and losing an IO is not a big deal, and it's really hard to choose which one to focus since they both can have a pretty good shot at saving one another. So yeah, these supports, Lina as well as Shadow Demon, kind of awkwardly positioned right now, but even if they may not be able to get those kills, there's always the jungle. Not a big deal, just go there and you'll be pretty happy.
And still, both of these teams are farming at a reasonable rate across the board compared to each other. The only exception is the Tiny versus the Queen of Pain. Kendrick is struggling a little bit. The Eye has been playing a very hands-off role, trying to get Tiny his levels as much as possible, and that's going to allow the Queen of Pain to get a little bit of work, but those IO illusions just killed Radiant's Courier. Welp.
Apparently, illusion runes are the best runes in Dota. TIL, Necroman's gonna get Avitossed over in mid, and he doesn't have a bottle. He'll have to blink out of there. That is not the play that I would expect from an IO to ever really make happen, but hey, there's two of them, and the courier got a little bit of distance away from it, but now Necroman's lane, not completely lost, but really, really bad at this stage. Like, just the spam of avalanches making it really difficult. Fedj, he's gonna chase forward for MDL, sees the Shadow Demon, quickly realizes he should not be chasing that far, but Tusk is actually looking to cut them off. The Bane is the target right now, and RNT, he's going to go straight for him, has the shards and the snowball, but it's going to get put to sleep immediately. It's going to get taken off by the shield. Now they catch Fedj in a corner. Shock's taking a lot of damage, however, by the Ember Spirit. Necroman's going to arrive, and they put the Shadow Demon in a bubble. Milan has enough damage to get this kill with one more right click. He's going to get the last hit, but now they might also lose the Bane with an LSA landing. It's a 2-for-1. And that is actually a pretty decent trade for Team Turkey, as they don't lose anyone else. Losing First Blood, yeah, never optimal, but taking down the Ember Spirit for it, that is, you know, going to balance that out in quite a big way.
Yeah, the disadvantage here is the fact that they're going to leave the Tiny completely alone in the mid lane, is that does force a rotation off of mid from the Quap, but with the Haste Rune, Necroman's going to be able to run towards mid, and as you said, I think Turkey will be doing just fine, or feeling just fine about that trade, especially since Lifestealer is doing very well against this Nyx. 25-3 compared to 18-3. Both of these heroes are farming, but there's nothing the Nyx Assassin can do to stop the Lifestealer. Even the mana burn, which is a nuisance, really isn't doing that much. Lifestealer's mana pool's not that impressive already, and who needs mana to CS on Lifestealer? He benefits mostly just from Feast and large base damage.
Never felt so good to be so dumb. Over towards mid lane, Kendrick is going to jump in again towards Necroman, forcing out the blink. And Pwn is going to get his wounds open up on the top lane. He has Spiked Carapace, but now Lifestealer is going to pop the Rage. We'll block all of that, so Spiked Carapace down the tube. He's going to chow down on the Mango. Has the Impale Shock, though, going to close in for the Curse and the Disruption onto Pwn. Is he completely trapped? No, he's not. His illusions are going to get dissipated immediately. Shock's going to drop to Fedj. Infest damage, not enough to kill off the Nyx Assassin. Klazinki is probably not going to die here, although there is... Okay, no, I thought that was a Tiny. It's just an IO. A little bit of movement speed, perhaps. They have another Brain Sap and Nightmare soon. Klazinki doesn't have any mana or anything like that, but it looks like he's just fast enough to get out of there. But yeah, it is going to be a dive a little bit too deep for an Assassin, who is a pretty high armor target with 5 and Stout Shield, so he's going to be resistant to that enough. Going back to that Necroman rotation, however, towards the bottom lane, that actually, I think, is the correct move, even though you do give Tiny farm. As a bottleless Queen of Pain, you don't want to be going toe-to-toe versus an IO Tiny. You would rather leave the lane and try to get those kills. So, yeah,
I think so too.
A pretty decent early start for Necroman, even with the bottle loss.
Yeah, the bottle loss, although it has given Tiny a little bit of an edge over the Queen of Pain, it's not a super significant one. Since they're sharing experience, the Queen of Pain actually has a slight XP lead over the Tiny, although once he starts farming these stacks, that'll be different. Tiny spotted out by the very early ward that was placed down. They know that Tiny does have stacks created for him, and maybe he'll be able to contest it. Although, as a whole, the Radiant heroes aren't that great at taking stacks. Although Queen of Pain can, it is a lot longer than other heroes. Down towards bottom, Snowball away, the Tusk will buy himself some safety, but Ember Spirit, without level 6, is going to get caught out by the Shadow Demon. Potentially, the chains are going to be dropped. They have a disruption, looking for the Light Strike Ray, but that Flame Guard doing a massive amount of damage to MGL and Shock. Is it enough to save Milan's life? It looks like no, because Necromant's coming in for another rotation, canceling the salve with the Shadow Strike. It will be lethal. Queen of Pain finds himself a kill onto Milan.
I think the most surprising part about that was how much damage that Flame Guard did. Like, it almost just destroyed Shock and MDL, but no big deal as long as you get the kill. I really do like also the play from RNT was playing as if nothing was wrong. He had to snowball to the creep wave and, you know, threw out some shards, kind of scared looking as the Tusk, but no, he knew that he had backup coming in, so it was just a very, very elaborate bait. Sometimes acting as a hero, a little bit difficult to do, but when you do it correctly, it works out very well. Killing off an Ember Spirit again in the support duo, now maybe looking to go towards the enemy jungle. They again know that the stacks are there. They're going to smoke up and they want to go steal the stack. Unfortunately, it's going to be a little bit late. Kendrick has already cleared out most of it. Is super weak along with Vita, so they may actually get in here just in time. Another toss is here. Creeps are still alive and the smoke is not quite approaching fast enough. Even if they don't get any of these creeps, killing off Kendrick and Vita here is totally worth it since they're worth so much now, but it's just too late. I love the attempt. I love the idea here for Team Turkey, but it's unfortunately the timing is just not right.
Yeah, as you said, the plan was good. The timing for it, not so much. A second earlier, literally just a second or two, and they would have been able to catch them out. Still, the Lifestealer's farming. What do you think he's going to build into this game? For now, it's just Phase Boots, Orb of Venom. Pretty standard Lifestealer fare.
Yeah, he might be going for a Hand of Midas, given how much free farm he is getting up towards top, but, you know, just going for a regular Sanji and Yasha, going for a Basher, mixing that in, is usually fine. We have a Vendetta down towards the bottom lane. Nyx Assassin wants this Tusk, but similarly over towards mid, they want the Tiny. Shock and MDL kind of hiding there, but RNT is going up against so many heroes right now, gets put to sleep. Impale's going to completely whiff, and now he's a Snowball. This is a 1v4, but you can't crack the Snowball. He's going to go towards Milan, away from his backup. He's going to get brainstabbed, punches up the Nyx Assassin, now gets put into a bubble. Shock's going to buy himself a little bit of time now, because Link is going to come in straight towards Milan, but he doesn't have a remnant place before. He's going to get out of there. Pwn, maybe not as lucky. Hasplay Carapace will buy himself a second or two, but he's not going to get out of there. He's going to fall. Can they catch anyone else? It looks like it's just going to be a deep, deep dive for a 1-for-1 trade.
Kuzinki. In mid lane, looking for MDL. Lightstrike Ray is going to miss. He has an Avalanche in 5 seconds, and will be able to kill MDL with it. Trying for the neutral deny. Tiny is going to say no to that one. Kills her off with the toss. Level 2 is more than enough to get that kill on support. But yep, they're going to jump forward for Milan. He does have another remnant with the Mango. Would have had enough mana to use it. Turns around for Necroman. Does not have chains for a while. Avalanche Dawes combination. Going to drop Kuzinki low with Rage. Lifestealer will survive if only just Snowball forward. Walrus Punch kills off the Io. And Ember Spirit will be able to make his way out towards right hand side. Kuzinki's looking for round number 2. Doesn't have full mana for his combination, but does have a level 4 Avalanche. He has an Invis Pwn here as well. The counter initiation could come through as the Radiant team is also there in force. It looks like nobody's going to make the jump yet, although it is a bit of a tense situation. They're going to look for Necroman. The Impale is going to miss again and a blink away from the Queen of Pain, and she's going to be just fine. Snowball forward. Defensive Nightmare is going to stop that Walrus Punch. Brain Sap onto RNT. The Tusk is going to be forced back. But now Lifestealer opens the Wounds of Pwn, chasing into this Nyx Assassin. He does not have a Spike Carapace. Even if he did, the Rage would have stopped that. Can't even get the Impale to land before he goes down on anybody on the back lines. And just like that, 6-4 is our kill score when the dust settles. What a mess in the mid lane.
What the hell happened to this game? Like, they were just happily farming for so long, and all of a sudden, everyone decides that it's time to fight. And after all said and done, I do think it's Team Turkey to get the slight edge off of all those fights. Necroman surviving that run-in with the Tiny, and now Shock is in a little bit of trouble. Gets the Ember Spirit in the bubble, but he's got to deal with the Bane. He just wants to D-ward. Unfortunately for him, it's not going to happen. And, they will lose their sentry there. But yeah, Shadow Demon, it's an expendable hero at this point for Team Turkey. But Necroman surviving is a big deal. Also, the Lifestealer has yet to die. Compared that to the Ember Spirit, who has died twice now. The Tiny is still surviving. And oh, we have Milan running into Necroman. He will dodge a Sonic Wave with the jump away. Necroman almost getting that kill, but not quite. But now the Shard's going to catch the Bane. He has a Brain Sap level 3, but it's not going to help him if he just gets nuked down. Can't even cast that one, as it's Lina to draw that kill. Only level 4 on the hero, but is involved in quite a few of these kills. And a level 6 Lina given the amount of fights in this game, can swing these fights very hard to the side of the Radiant.
Yeah, absolutely. Still a little while before she's going to have that very crucial level 6 mark. He's about to take level 5 in just a second. Even though the life store is being involved in more kills and getting more farm, that solo kill that Tiny got seems to have given him enough gold to where he's able to keep up, and now accelerating his farm through the jungle is also going to help a lot. Tiny is able to benefit from stacks much greater than the Lifestealer, and it looks like Lifestealer might be building into drums, just going for as cost-efficient, aggressive items as he can. He's going to chase for Milan, but there's always a remnant. At the very least, he's going to get a lot of harass onto him.
And he also doesn't really want to chase super aggressively, knowing that, of course, the remnant is placed. He saw it placed, and he also doesn't know what level the IO is. Right now, though, they're going to intercept Kendrick and Vita. Sigil's overhead. Vita's in a lot of trouble. He'll just get beaten down. Now Kendrick in a corner has tossed no avalanche, however, so MDL is going to survive. They put him in the bubble to dodge snowball damage, unfortunately, but they still have more than enough damage to work this Tiny down. Double kill again for RNT. Is that his completed mech? It seems like it is.
Oh, no, being too.
Same time, Fedge in a little bit of trouble. Shard's going to come through. He gets the Nightmare off, but that's not going to save him. Nightmare gets pulled off by Shock. Necroman is going to now drop a sentry. They see Pwn. He's going to try to go for MDL, but he's going to fall short. He needs one more right click. Oh, the snowball a little bit too late. Lina's going to fall. Now here comes Milan. Shard's going to block off the escape route of Pwn. Kozlicki's going to get right on top of Necroman. He's now going to try to go for Vita. Milan's going to fan out some spirits, but the Lifestealer is still at full HP. He's still swinging and swinging hard. Milan's going to chase forward, looking for RNT. The Illusion's going to take some of the chains. Kozlicki's going to close in and force the jump away from the Ember Spirit. Again, the IO Tiny pickoff in and of itself would have made that a great trade for the Turkey side, but taking all those kills as just bonus, yeah, they're starting to pull ahead.
The end gold swing is almost 1600 in the favor of the Radiant side. They only lose their two supports, and really that doesn't mean too much. In such a clumped fight, again, we get to see the power of the Flame Shield coming out from the Ember Spirit. It does so much inside these engagements, but we haven't seen very many full Avatoss combos on single targets. The Tiny tends to be focused down very nicely after the rest of his allies die, and Kendrick's forced to use his toss mostly defensively, which is unfortunate for the Tiny. A full Avatoss is more than enough to kill off the likes of the Shadow Demon or the Lina, maybe even just with that combo, but with a couple of auto attacks after the fact, definitely. It feels like Radiant is starting to pull ahead, and they're going to push this advantage by going for a Midas on the Lifestealer, and I think that's absolutely fine. Kozlicki's been getting so much room that I'm a little bit surprised he didn't get the Midas earlier.
Just a couple minutes ago, Shock was level 3 and MDL was level 4. Now they're both closing in at level 6. And when you're fighting this often, well, he's going to get avalanched, not tossed. Open wounds onto Kendrick. Vita going to arrive and scare off the Lifestealer. Fair enough. No one's going to die up towards the top. But we have teleportations, two of them, in fact. They're just looking to fight. Here's the Infest Bomb on the Tusk. Snowball delivery system. Sure, whatever works. There is a relocate here on the IO. So you're going to have to play around that. Shard's going to connect, seeing both, trapping both. It seems like the IO Tiny are not going to get baited by an over-aggressive Tusk. They know that something's up with this.
Yeah, but they also have the Blink Dagger on the Tiny. Even when partnered up with the IO, I'd like to see Blink so he can benefit from the Avatoss combo on these squishier heroes, like the Lina, like the Shadow Demon, can very easily get kills, as I mentioned earlier. And if the Tiny can start the fights in a 4v5 fashion for their team, Team Bosnia could very easily take this game out, although for now the momentum is in Turkey's favor. The Lifestealer has wasted quite a lot of time by being inside of this Tusk. His Midas is going to come off a cooldown in about 12 seconds, and at that time I'd expect him to pop out. There's no real reason for him to stick around inside this Tusk. I don't think they're going to find the opportunity that they really wanted.
They're really just playing the slow roll, the patient game, hoping that the next assassin pops out of nowhere and tries to go for this Tusk. That's where Lifestealer really wants to be, but that's not going to happen. In the meantime, well, everyone's over in the mid lane, right between the tier 1 and tier 2. Necroman hiding in a corner, thinking about going for one of these heroes possibly. He does not see the IO, he only sees the Tiny. It's a little bit too much for just the Queen of Pain to handle. But after all said and done, it's a tower to be destroyed and nothing else really, although Queen of Pain is going to teleport towards mid. Has a blink, but the Nightmare into Impale setup is almost a guaranteed land. Oh, she's going to jump away, seeing the Ember Spirit coming in. Double TPs are incoming. Shadow Demon's going to be first. He's going to have to put himself in the bubble. Impale is going to be there, plus the relocate. Kozlicki's going to arrive, as will the IO Tiny combo, but instantly there's the grip, and they don't have anything in the area to actually cancel it. They're going to try to burst down the Bane, but it's just not enough. Necroman will have to blink over, and it will not work. Kozlicki's going to get a lot of infest damage onto everyone. Now here comes Snowball onto Kendrick. Dragon Slave through. That's going to get RNT yet another double kill. They're onto Milan now, who has no more mana for a spirit, but it looks like it doesn't matter. He'll get out of there just fine. Bane Tiny versus Queen of Pain Shadow Demon. Actually, the golden EXP trade is actually completely even, but that's not really how you want to use your first relocate.
Yeah, and also it's going to be gold lost on the Queen of Pain, gold lost on the Tiny. Across the board, it does feel very even. the big winner inside that engagement is the Tusk, as RNT almost gets 600 gold from that fight and is now the majority of the way towards a Blink Dagger. This Tusk is the second highest net worth on his team, 8-1-5. He's had a great game, and I see that staying the case for the Tusk. When you get these early levels, especially against squishy heroes like the Io, get on top of it, blow up the Io. 796 HP pool is not terrible for a support, but the biggest issue is the one armor. That Walrus Punch is going to sting.
Yeah, I think that's, he got like 3 double kills also, so he's been, you know, getting a whole bunch of pairs of kills. Like, they're boarding the arc, and RNT, well, going for Guardian Greaves maybe eventually, but hell, at this point, with the amount of fighting that we've seen, with the amount of farm that the Tusk is able to accrue in the level as well, you could even start considering just going for like a straight Shadow Blade or just a straight Blink Dagger. In fact, with the amount of gold that he's holding, it looks like Blink Dagger is a little bit more likely, but yeah, RNT is going to be a very significant threat. I guess the downside is that the Queen of Pain doesn't exactly have as much. 218 though is a respectable score, and yeah, really, she's toe-to-toe with the Tiny. Is not too far behind the Ember Spirit, just 200 net worth difference. Queen of Pain doesn't look like she's keeping up with her allies, because she isn't, but she's keeping up with all the enemies, and that's really what counts.
Yeah, absolutely. And having that Yules is very good this game. It's another tool to cancel out Vayne's Fiend's Grip. And also, the purge against Ember Spirit's Flame Guard is very important. The Demonic Purge from the Shadow Demon, although in theory would be really good, still not level 6 on him. And it'll reduce a lot of Ember's damage inside these fights. We've seen how much Milan's able to do with that. Not only it takes away his damage, but also a lot of his survivability. The magic nukes haven't been bothering Ember Spirit too much until now, but they will be in the next couple of fights. Ember Spirit, however, is also not looking too terrible. He's neck and neck with the Tiny, Tusk, and Queen of Pain in farm after the drums going towards his Battle Fury.
One sword already up, has to build towards that Perseverance. Another big item that the Radiant will have sooner rather than later, it seems, support Lina with 1,200 gold, going for a Yule Scepter of her own, obviously to set herself up, but for all the same reasons you listed for the Queen of Pain. Having two of them means that you can do twice as much, or just go for Point Booster. This is the build that MDL has been going on his past Linas that I've seen over the past couple of games. And, well, Flame Guard is really good. We've seen it be really good. Pure damage doesn't care about it, and we'll just cut straight through. Kluzinki is going to go for the value Lifestealer build, it seems. Midas into drums completed into what looks like an armlet. So yeah, he's going to be ready to go very shortly.
Yeah, and with these items, Lifestealer is going to be able to contribute a lot. If he goes for something like a Basher after that, it's going to be very hard for Bosnia to manage the Lifestealer in the couple of seconds when he's magic immune. They'll need to get a good grip, and Vayne has no way to protect that grip. Mid lane relocate, they're going to go into MTL. The Lina is pretty much assuredly going to fall. They'll throw an Avalanche towards Kluzinki, but he already got off. His Rage, still the Vendetta is going to sting, looking for the impel, trying to juke it out. He's very fast, but not fast enough. Blink Toss to secure the kills. Lifestealer will be cratered on the sidelines. Tusk is going to be gripped under the tower. Sonic Wave from the top is good. He'll be able to get off the mechanism, but won't save his own life. The only hero to get in response is the Bane because of the Sonic Wave commitment. That is a huge turn of events for Bosnia, and almost a 2,000 gold and experience swing going in their favor.
Oh, jump forward. He's going to look for another impale. Will miss, but the Avalanche will not. Shoxina tossed up, will again fall. And that is another kill chalked up for Bosnia's side. Just a momentary, I guess, lapse of positioning for the Radiant. Lifestealer should really not get hit by any of these combos from the Io Tiny if he's really on point with his Rage. You know, everyone else just falling because they're just so, so soft. This mobility from the Assassin and Tiny going to be still a threat that if Turkey are not completely prepared for, may just end up falling too. 15-13, and Bosnia just got a hell of a lot off of that. The second sword for the Ember Spirit, and he has one part of the Perseverance now available to him. Tiny starting to build towards his Aghanim Scepter. I mean, they still have to deal with the super farm Lifestealer, Queen of Pain, and Tusk all not doing too badly, but just after that series of fights, suddenly Ember Spirit skyrocketed to the top of the net worth chart.
Yeah, and with that amount of farm, they can very easily give the Lifestealer a run for his money. A lot of physical damage on this Ember Spirit could make it very difficult for them to keep him in place, although the Shadow Demon Disruption to Lightstrike Array is a decent combination. They'll probably need to commit the Tusk's kit as well to reliably kill him off, and then you have a Tiny that's unanswered, who by himself can do a ridiculous amount. That also relies on Ember Spirit getting caught out of position. Not to say that that's impossible, but right now the Ward Vision coming out from Dire is pretty good, but it doesn't spot out, no, this rotation. But what does is a Nyx Assassin right around the corner. He's going to stock these supports. They're going to dust up the Nyx, looks for the impale, going to miss. Stuck inside those Ice Shards, Remnant forward, the Shadow Demon will die in the backline, so an Avatoss combination very easily done by Kendrick, but now they catch out MDL. Chasing forward with that IO movement speed, Lightstrike is going to completely miss as he was trying to buy himself a little bit of space. The Blink toss, Yule Scepter is going to delay, but Fiend's Grip will kill off the Tusk, and that's another three kills for Team Bosnia as they're starting to get so much momentum. Of course, the Lifestealer has his Armlet and is by no means doing poorly, but the Armlet on Lifestealer is going to mean so much less than like the Blink on the Tiny or the Battle Fury, which is going to be done in just a couple of seconds for the Ember Spirit.
That smoke was also seen by Bosnia. They like got right in at the edge of this observer ward in the mid lane, so they were prepared for it. Pwn, oh, is gonna get his wounds open up down towards bottom lane, but here comes the relocation help. Pwn's gonna get four staffed out. He's gonna survive for a little while longer. Necroman gonna dodge the avalanche, will blow up the IO, but gets tossed up, needs a blink out, will instead decide to Yule's, then blink. Can she get away? She will. Straight TP. Ember Spirit gonna jump after her. Damage over time, it's gonna be enough. Albeit barely. Milan's gonna get that kill on the Queen of Pain in a 1-for-1 trade that, well, Team Turkey really don't want to be making. But yeah, they did see that smoke coming, so they were prepared. Also, the fact that they didn't dust up immediately could have probably picked off that Nyx Assassin if they knew that it was Nyx to blow the smoke, but that's not something that you know all the time unless you have a gem. Now Nyx Assassin on the hunt for Klazinki. Unfortunately, they don't have any relocate here, but with Ember Spirit right around the corner, maybe try for it? You can just see how much damage you can do, I guess. They're going to need the Vendetta hit if they're going to get this kill. Battle Fury now up, and, well, he sees the Courier. Here comes the IO. Klazinki knows he's in a lot of trouble right now. He's going to try to go for Vita, who just responded. Now here comes the backup. Snowball through onto Pwn. Walrus Punch is going to be there, stalling up Pwn a little bit. They take out the IO. Nice two-man impale. And if Edge is also here as well, they'll take down the Lina and the Tusk straight after. Milan's going to grab an instant double kill. Unstoppable streak on the Ember Spirit. They don't get the target that they wanted, but they get two others, and that's not bad at all.
Especially when they only lose the IO. As well as everybody on their team is doing, the IO is the target they're most willing to give up. And that said, the IO still has everything it needs to contribute. Tranquil, Soul Ring, Bottle, Stick, and an Urn. These are all the cost-efficient sustaining items that you'd expect and want to have. And that was also a fight without the Tiny. It could have been a lot worse for Turkey if the Tiny was around. Instead, he was farming up his Aghanim Scepter. And he does have that completed now. They take a couple of pickoffs, they buy time for Kendrick to finish up that Ags, and this Tiny is a force to be reckoned with. With the maxed out toss, 2 points up in the grow with the Aghanims, his Avatoss combo is going to be doing a ridiculous amount. On top of that, his farming speed is also going to be absurd. The cleave from the Ember Spirit and the Tiny is going to be farming much faster than the Ember Spirit. Klazinki has gone for a very cost-efficient build to kill off heroes, and it's working to whenever he gets on top of the IO, but that's just not happening very often. The partnership of either the Tusk or the Queen of Pain with the Lifestealer's Infest hasn't worked for them, although they've tried a couple of times. They're going to group up in top lane, trying to kill off Kendrick, and maybe, just maybe, this will work. Dire's Vision is not all that impressive to protect their own jungle, and Kendrick might be walking into a bee's nest of enemy heroes, although they also see the Lina and the Tusk on the back lines. They're going to look for a potential wraparound of their own. As they send Pwn to scout out in front, they're going to see the Tusk, they're going to see MDL in just a second, they see the entire enemy team, but he walks right into a sentry ward. Disruption to Lightstrike Ray, Avalanche is going to be thrown, but he's stunned up. The Sonic Wave, Lacuna Blade, Tusk is going to go down. Milan is going to join the fray, but the Ember Spirit's very low and has to remnant all the way back down to the bottom lane, chasing forward for the Bane, opening his wounds. They'll chase him down with a defensive relocate just a little further towards the south. They are going to be able to buy themselves a little bit of extra time that they needed. I think that relocate was used earlier in that fight, so the IO isn't going to be going back anywhere to put herself at risk, or itself rather. They still lose their Tiny, they still lose their Nyx, now they're going to lose a tier 2 tower after the fact. It's going to be Turkey to bring back some momentum on their side.
Man, MDL made a pretty ballsy call there. They got the disruption on Nyx Assassin, and as Nyx Assassin, when you're disrupted, what you immediately press is that Spike Carapace button, and Lina should know about that, yet she threw the LSA anyway, and it ended up hitting the Tiny, who figured there's no way she throws the LSA into the Spike Carapace. I'm just gonna blink in, but he blinked into an LSA, and then got hit with a Sonic Wave, and then everything in the book. So Tiny didn't stand a chance in hell there, because he just got hit with a stun right after his blink before he can get anything off. And, you know, maybe in a different situation, MDL decides to hold on to that stun and try to bait out the Spike Carapace for a little while longer, but just decided to go for the stun, and it ended up working so well for her. This Lifestealer, I was just about to say, and you were saying that he is now up against quite a few anti-Lifestealer tools, like Milan is just naturally anti-Lifestealer, Bane has the grip and he's going for a little bit of invis, so Glimmer Cape can make it much more difficult for the Lifestealer to catch up to his targets, Force Staff on the Nyx Assassin. Yet after all said and done, he's not going to go for Bastion to try to keep up to his targets as a Desolator. He is counting on the Lina and on the Tusk on his team to keep him close enough to at least get the kill very quickly on one hero. Necroman though is going to get chased down, Sleight of Fist, no Searing Chains. the neutral is going to ward them away. Necroman's going to get out of there just fine, closing in on his Aghanim Scepter, but do they really want to turn this one around? They're going to run into Pwn, or at least RNT will. This is not a fight that they want, but they're actually going to catch Mulan. Screen of Pain not going to do nearly enough. Demonic Purge is there. Queen of Pain, though, dropping super low. Has to blink out right into the clutches of Nyx's Assassin. Nyx overshot, but will get the kill in the end. But probably will get punished because he's completely surrounded. Open Wounds is there. He's going to force staff forward, but that's not going to work out. Laguna Blade actually going to be dodged by the Disruption of Shock. Not going to matter. It's going to get the lifesteal of the kill in the end, so that actually probably helped them a little bit, I guess. It's going to be Queen of Pain for Nyx's Assassin. Still a decent trade for Bosnia. However, they're not done yet. Tusk, he's going to get lifesteal infested inside of him. Jump forward, looking for this Io. Shards are there. He's going to tether straight towards Kendrick, but he doesn't really have much of a backup plan since the Tiny has already left. The Io's going to fall. No, actually, Tiny got interrupted out of his TP by MDL, and now Kendrick's on the run to the south. Snowball forward for three heroes. He's completely surrounded. Desolator minus armor. Going to do some work, although Craggy Exterior is going to be inconvenient. They'll work him down eventually. That's going to be a whole slew of kills, all in exchange for just the Queen of Pain. That's a massive win now for Team Turkey.
In isolation, just the Nyx Assassin for the Queen of Pain is really good for Bosnia because the Nyx Assassin is able to buy his Blink Dagger after that kill. Still, losing the IO Tiny partnership is really bad. That TP almost worked out for the Tiny, but just a little bit too late. The Lina was there with a nice Light Striker ready to cancel that one through, and just like that, Bosnia are going to lose a couple of heroes here and there. That said, the Ember Spirit still doing quite well, and they catch out Necroman again. This time around, it's going to be relocated in with the Nyx Assassin, and they'll find themselves that kill. The Io is going to be going back towards base, and it looks like he might bring the Ember Spirit with him. No, they'll just leave Mulan. He dropped a Renan. That's the only reason why I thought he might want to go back to base, but still, that is going to be Bosnia killing off Quap again. Necroman is severely going to be hampered his iron progression after dying twice in quick succession, losing, give or take, about 800 gold across both of those.
And you're just not finding farm on this bottom lane. If you're not farming there as Queen of Pain, that 800 gold is not going to be easy to balance out in the end. Looks like they kind of want to make another Infest play, although they're all sitting on the Radiant side right over a Dire Observer. This is awkward. They're going to think about moving forward. Yeah, the Infest is there, but this is not a surprise, although RNT still has the Blink Dagger. He's going to jump right in, sees Kendrick, open Wounds is going to be used on Kendrick as well. Roshan, though, is going to slow him down. Snowball forward. Kendrick's still alive because of the Glimmer Cape. And RNT dropping low. Now Kozinki is going to get hit with the Grip. Not taking any damage from this, but no one's going to break it thus far. Lina will fall in the back lines. Veg finally will die. Looking for maybe another Brain Sap. Doesn't have enough mana to do it. RNT somehow still surviving. Pwn can grab the Bounty Rune. Blink up to the high ground, but right into Necroman's clutches. He has no Spike Carapace. He has a Force Staff over the Shards, but it's not going to save him forever. He's going to try to go for Necroman with the Spike Carapace now up. Sonic Wave will be returned. Necroman's going to kill himself. Kozinki now stunned up by the Carapace as well. Going to try to go for Mulan, but he's lost all his backup and is burning. He's going to have to Armlet Toggle his way out of here, but Kendrick's doing so much damage, he's not even going to Armlet Toggle. Kendrick's going to grab the triple kill. And for Bosnia, they lose two heroes but gain five. What an exchange. This game is just going back and forth.
And that's just like we like it. Now it's Bosnia's turn to take an objective. They're going to go into Roshan. A lot of the innate weaknesses of the lifesteal are starting to show. He's getting kited quite incessantly. When he's hitting targets, he's doing so much damage with that Desolator Armlet. It's quite impressive. But he needs some allies to set up for him. And it's not happening because generally they're just dying outright, especially with that Queen of Pain. Unfortunately, in that last fight, as you said, returning the Sonic Wave, it did so much damage to her. That's not something that any hero can really manage. Queen of Pain, no exception. They'll take down Roshan, TP the Io back to base, have an Aegis now on their Tiny with 3,000 gold on top of it. And Bosnia also have an Ancient Stack. As pointed out, that 3-stack of Ancients is going to be a lot of farm for Kendrick.
Whether it's Ember Spirit or Tiny to clear that one out, doesn't really matter because the Radiant side don't really have the proper heroes to steal that stack. Queen of Pain, again, just going down. This time she gets a kill and she's still surfing around 800 gold, but she really does need to start gaining gold instead of just breaking even. Lifesteal has grabbed himself a Hyperstone. You're definitely doing a lot more damage in these fights, but up against the naturally Lifestealer-resistant lineup of Bosnia, will struggle. In fact, at this point, MDL is going to complete his Aghanim Scepter before the Queen of Pain. You know, there's a Yule Scepter behind, but still, we have a Laguna Blades level 2 with Aghanims only 100 gold away. That cutting through the Ember Spirit, the immense physical damage from the Lifestealer, it's not looking the best right now for Team Turkey as they have, you know, given quite a bit of gold away to Bosnia, but still far from over. Kozinki gonna get dropped 500 HP by one Sleight of Fissuring Chains with a crit now up on Mulan, a big one, Daedalus. This Lifestealer needs the Assault Cuirass so badly just for the armor.
Yeah, absolutely, and Also, another Glimmer Cape is going to be coming out very shortly for Bosnia. We saw how important that last Glimmer Cape was, the Bane's Glimmer Cape on Kendrick in the fight around the Roshan Pit. This magic resistance is going to be less impactful. Oh, Blink Water's Punch down towards bottom. Nah, he's going to be able to remnant out to safety. Their lockdown just isn't enough to deal with this Ember. They really need a Scythe of Ice on the Queen of Pain, but since she's struggling so much just to get that Aghanim's after the Yules, that's going to be a long time incoming.
They do see Pwn coming in, I think. Oh, and the Lifestealer is none too healthy right now. He'll try to TP out. Spike's going towards Shock instead. Searing Chain's gonna miss, but he's actually gonna cancel his TP out. Now turn around and start to fight. He's gonna try to go for Vita, but Vita with the short tether out is Force Staff out, is gonna be just fine. Spirit still tracking Klazinki as Vita. Now gonna go Invis, and Klazinki doesn't have any true side here. Here comes the Bane with the grip. Klazinki's gonna fall. Where did the backup go? It's all going towards the top lane. They aren't going to be able to kill off the Io in the end. Everyone just abandoned that scenario. And the Dire now are working with so much momentum, they can go for possibly even both of these tier 2 towers.
Yeah, that was a little bit awkward for them. Lifestealer, I'm going to check the combat log to see if he canceled that TP or not. But still was left alone. He does put up a very good fight against these heroes, but ooh, Tiny going to dive in the top lane to the creeps of all things, but now in bottom, Milan kills off the poor Shadow Demon. They'll finish up the Io too. That's pretty nice for the Radiant side, since it is just the Shadow Demon to fall for that Io Tiny partnership, but they're going to lose the tier 2 tower just the same, even though they do get a decent trade, almost a 3,000 swing in their favor in golden experience. It's going to cost them map control, and that's something that they really can't afford losing.
And that's permanent map control down the tubes, whereas for the Io Tiny in 40 seconds, they'll be still around with their relocate. Oh, Dewman stun onto MTL and RNT. Follow-up, kind of slow incoming as Ember Spirit's going to wander in. Has his shield available, hasn't put it up just yet. He doesn't have to worry about a Laguna Blade. It was used to kill off that Io Tiny combo. Ember Spirit will jump out of there. Everyone else will leave, although RNT is going to throw some shards, which will wall off and trap too. He doesn't have anything else, however. He'll just get obliterated immediately. They put Necroman to sleep by now. Here comes Klazinki. We'll tear the Nyx Assassin to shreds. Now looking for the Bane. Necroman's going to jump forward. Shadow Strike to get the slow down. Klazinki just needs a couple of seconds. There we go. 2-3 right clicks. That's going to be the kill on that Bane. Now they lift up the Ember Spirit into the air. He does have a backup Remnant. He's going to have to deploy it. We'll dodge the Laguna Blade damage with it. And yeah, he's going to get right back out to safety. He's going to be just fine. That's still not a great trade, however, for the Bosnia side. That's the type of scenario where you want to have, you need to have, your Io Tiny relocate in, but just not in time.
It could have been a lot worse. Ember Spirit surviving that Laguna Blade is such a clutch play coming out from Milan. It means so much. If they're able to kill off the Ember there, the Ember Spirit's at the top of the net worth chart. That would have been a lot of gold, not only for their side, but also a good amount of gold lost by the Ember, since he is pooling so much gold with almost 1,400 unreliable. And well, for now, Bosnia, although repelled, are still in the driver's seat. They have the Assault Cuirass done on the Tiny, which helps so very much against the Lifestealer in particular. Although Lifestealer is still going to be trucking and has almost the finished Assault Cuirass of his own, just needs 200 gold to have that finished for Klazinki. At least Kendrick's going to have some tool to mitigate the impact of it.
At this point, the Tiny has just so much armor. He can maybe not fight Lifestealer toe-to-toe, but with the Io, he definitely can put up a fighting chance. They both have a lot of armor now, so that's going to be a very slow fight if it ever does come to fruition. But Ember Spirit, he's still doing a hell of a lot of damage, so Tiny's like a threat, but Ember Spirit's the bigger one. Oh, MDL trying to go for the Blink LSA. Probably not going to work ever versus an Ember Spirit, but hey, might as well try. Up towards top lane, RNT's going to hit with the Avalanche. He has Lifestealer right inside him. Snowball's there to protect him. Slinky and Kendrick going to go toe-to-toe. Relocate out is going to save the Tiny. However, Vita is not looking too great here. Has a Nyx Assassin coming in to tether to, and there aren't really many disables, so they're going to have to use Disruption here. Vita is going to put into a bubble, but now he's kind of screwed. Shards will block him. He's going to Glimmer out. There's no True Sight? Okay, well, there's no True Sight. The Io lives.
Yeah, as far as the detection situation for them, the only one that has it is the Shadow Demon, and Shock was a little too far away to reliably chase for that, since they know there's an Assassin there. There could have been an Ember, and speaking of which, he's going to get a long catch onto the Shadow Demon, Blink into the Impel, they mana burn him, and Milan finds the kill. Ember Spirit is godlike. That was such a long jump for them. Now they're going to look in mid. Raising the arms for Fiend's Grip. Not going to happen, but Ember Spirit's going deep. He's going to catch an Avalanche toss on Klitsinki. They'll blow up the lifesteal with the Fiend's Grip. He can't do anything. Sonic Wave over a lot of heroes, but Necroman's going to be stunned up, I believe, by the Spike Carapace. Laguna Blade to Milan is not going to be lethal. Toss to the Queen of Pain. She's going to go down. The chains of the MDL mean that she can't follow up onto Milan. The Queen of Pain has since fallen. MDL is the only survivor. Avalanche will miss. The Impale, however, will not. A triple kill for Milan. A full five-man wipe. As Turkey get nothing.
Man, that lifesteal just didn't stand a chance. The grip failed on the Lina, which usually looks pretty bad, but if you get the grip on the lifesteal, that's really what you want to be doing as the Pain. So Team Turkey, whether intentionally or not, just kind of played into Posnia's hands. And now their towers are going to take a sizable chunk of damage. We already know how much damage Tiny can do with just the IO with him. But with Milan next to him, they'll take down range. They'll take down melee. Over in the mid lane, Pwn has already started out with Fedge to take out the mid lane. And, well, Fortification is going to slow two fronts down, but, yeah, they need so much time to get this Lifestealer back. To have Turkey win a fight, or even take a fight without their Lifestealer, is probably just not going to happen. So, this is probably going to be two sets of Raxes in favor of now Team Bosnia. Yeah, Melee Rax is down now. Range Rax, they can fight, they can kill it or just back off. It's probably not going to make a terribly huge deal, but oh my god, that was one sleight of fist. 4/5 of Shock's HP down the tubes.
It's ridiculous. And also keep in mind, that fight, by the end of it, they had more than 10,000 gold pulled up on the Ember Spirit and Tiny combined. That's going to transition into a straight one-shot bot Manta, a straight one-shot bot Scotty, and the support's also benefiting. You have an Aghanim Scepter on this Nyx Assassin with Blink Force, Ghost Scepter. It's everything Nyx has ever dreamed of. And then Bane also has the Force Staff. Bosnia, even if they didn't take the barracks inside that last exchange, have a huge advantage. The Lifesteal and the Queen of Pain are just not nearly as good at dealing with creep waves as the Ember Spirit and the Tiny. If the Ember Spirit and the Tiny were the ones that were down to barracks, I say the chances for them coming back into the game are a lot better, but right now the advantage is absurd. After the dust settles, you're going to be almost at a 17,000 net worth advantage towards the Bosnia's side, and similar in experience lead. It's getting gross. They need to go for YOLO items. I think Lifesteal, if he builds anything defensive, can't really function. But if he doesn't build anything defensive, we'll just be kited around. It's a damned if you do, damned if you don't situation. They are going to look for a kill into the Vayne. They'll find it, but with a jump in toss, the snowball by time, they won't be able to kill MDL immediately. Can they get out safely? However, the Spike Carapace stunning Necroman is going to be crit down. Milan gets the double kill somehow. And now chasing forward, Klitsinki is running away. Armored on this Lifesteal activated. It's on very low amounts of HP. We chain to the floor and beat down. Triple kill for him as the next and chases down the Queen of Pain. GG, well played, and I don't blame them at all. That one fight for Bosnia won them the game outright, and that's how close this game was. And also, a little bit down to the nature of their heroes, Tiny is just that type of hero. If you lose one engagement to an Aghanim Scepter or a Salcuirass Tiny, he takes your entire base.
Man, I think if you look at the... I think it may be too late to... Oh, no. Oh, okay, now it is too late to look at the grass, but it was that, I think, one fight over in the mid lane. If you remember when they were, the Shadow Demon got picked off super early, the Lifestealer died, it was like a 3-0 or something like that. That gave so much momentum to the Bosnia side, and they just did not let up ever since that one botched engagement, the botched positioning fight, as I called it, from the Team Turkey side. So it is going to be Bosnia to grab 1 point off of this win. If they win the next one, it's 2 more. But still, it's not quite over for Team Turkey. They have another shot. It's the best of two, guys. I'm Mike Loris. I've been joined by Grandis V, so don't go anywhere. We'll see who is able to win the next game in just a little bit.